do you smoke or know someone who does? Then this program is meant for you. You will have a better understanding of what smoking does to your health. If you want to educate your kids about smoking, gather them around and watch this program together to talk about addiction and the dangers of smoking. That's today on Time Waits for No One.
From the office of Toledo Cardiology Consultants with Dr. Ameer Kabour, President and CEO, this is Time Waits for No One. Today, cigarette smoking will cause nearly 500,000 American deaths this year, and it's the number one preventable cause of death in the United States. The truth about smoking, that's today on Time Waits for No One, sponsored by Minx.
Hi, Time Waits for No One mission is to educate you about not only how to treat medical problems, but how to prevent it. Today, we will answer the question for you, why you should quit smoking. And in the next episode, we will answer the question how to treat lung problems from smoking. Let's start. Most people who smoke wish they did not. They live with a hatred for the habit they cannot seem to do without. They live with fear of serious illness and always have that awful feeling of being powerless to quit. Smokers live with the denial about what cigarettes are doing to them. Otherwise, there would be no comfort in smoking, no relief, and no pleasure. Let's learn how cigarette smoking and nicotine work on our body. After this sad story, let's look into the fact of smoking and try to understand it so we will not be in the same position of Bryan Curtis or his son.
Cigarette smoke contains more than 4,000 different chemicals, with nicotine being the primary component. Nicotine is a naturally occurring colorless liquid that comes from the tobacco plant. With each cigarette, a smoker takes in approximately 1 to 2 milligrams of nicotine. The smoker immediately experiences a high after exposure to nicotine due to the drug's stimulation of the adrenal glands and resulting secretion of epinephrine, also known as adrenaline. The rush of adrenaline stimulates the body and causes an increase in blood pressure, respiration, and heart rate. Nicotine also causes the release of dopamine in the brain. Dopamine is a chemical responsible for sensations of pleasure. The feelings of a high and of euphoria enhance nicotine's addictive effect. Repeated exposure to nicotine results in the development of tolerance, the condition in which higher doses of a drug are required to produce the same stimulating effects. When an adequate level of nicotine is not maintained, the smoker will experience symptoms of nicotine withdrawal.
Cigarettes are harmful because of the chemicals in it. Let's watch.
When you smoke, you inhale over 4,000 chemicals. It's a toxic, poisonous mix of substances, including ammonia, the bleach in toilet cleaner, acetone, the chemical in nail polish remover, benzene, found in paint stripper, and hydrogen cyanide, used in rat poison. And smoking delivers it straight into your body.
The Minx Grip Vascular Closure Device from Access Closure. The Minx Grip Vascular Closure Device offers an active, extravascular, patient-friendly closure solution that enables durable hemostasis without sutures or implants. The Minx Grip sealant is delivered through the existing procedural sheath, eliminating vessel trauma that is often caused by sheath exchange and tissue tract expansion. Temporary hemostasis is achieved first by placing an intra-arterial balloon, followed immediately by delivery of the Minx Grip sealant, which is positioned on the surface of the artery. After delivery, the Minx Grip sealant is compressed, accelerating expansion and adhesion to the vessel wall. The grip tip consists of two peg components. Once the grip tip enters the tissue tract, the body's temperature and pH level causes these two peg components to react and cross-link. As the cross-linking occurs, the grip tip softens and interlocks with the contours of the vessel wall, effectively gripping the artery and providing active closure. After the initial sealant expansion, the balloon is deflated and the device is removed. Platelets and blood cells continue to collect inside the Minx sealant's porous matrix, causing the sealant to swell 3 to 4 times its original size. Together, the Minx sealant and the grip tip produce a durable hemostasis and a platform for natural vessel healing. The sealant dissolves naturally through hydrolysis. Within 30 days, the sealant is completely reabsorbed, leaving nothing behind but a healed artery. Minx Grip grips on contact and leaves without a trace. Minx Grip is an active, extravascular, patient-friendly vascular closure device.
We know smoking kills, and that we are playing roulette with our health. However, we also know that most smoking-related disease takes years to develop. So we tell ourselves we have time and nothing will happen to us. You are wrong, my friend. 5 million people dying on the planet every year from tobacco use. And you need to realize that your chance as a smoker to get sick is increasingly and reasonably high. Smokers have a significant increase in their risk for health problems.
Every cigarette is doing you damage. Lungs are like sponges with millions of tiny air sacs for transferring oxygen. Every breath of tobacco smoke attacks them. No wonder smokers feel short of breath. Their lungs are rotting. This is a healthy lung. And this is the amount of tar a pack-a-day smoker breathes in every year. Every cigarette is doing you damage.
Smoking causes oral cancer. If it didn't, I wouldn't be needing chemotherapy.
If looking at mouth cancer on your cigarettes makes you uncomfortable, look at another part of the pack. Quitting is hard.
Not quitting is harder.
They call it throat cancer. They've come in and removed my voice box. Before they did this, they found out I got lung cancer as well. And the future plans right now are Alexander, my oldest, is coming over here for a holiday December 13th. I will be alive for that.
Smoking will cause one in every five deaths in the United States, up to four times coronary heart disease than non-smoker, including blockages and heart attack, up to four times more strokes, up to 13 times more death from COPD or chronic lung problems, and up to 23 times more lung cancer in men and 13 times in women. Smoking causes an estimated 80 to 90% of all lung cancer death. Smoking causes 90% of all death from COPD. Cancers related to smoking are leukemia, bladder cancer, cervical cancers, kidney cancers, lung cancer, mouth cancer, cancer of the larynx or voice box and throat cancer, pancreatic cancer, stomach cancers. Smoking increases the risk for infertility, preterm delivery in pregnant women, low birth weight, sudden infant death syndrome. Women who smoke have also increased risk for lower bone density postmenopause, increased risk for hip fracture.
Every cigarette is doing you damage. Every time you inhale, tobacco smoke condenses in your lungs to form tar. This is a healthy lung. And this is the amount of tar a pack-a-day smoker breathes in every year. Smoking creates blood clots, which can cause strokes. Some strokes kill, blind, or paralyze. Others you don't even know you're having. This is the result of a minor stroke in a smoker aged 38. Lungs are like sponges with millions of tiny air sacs for transferring oxygen. Every breath of tobacco smoke attacks them. No wonder smokers feel short of breath. Their lungs are rotting. New research shows how tobacco smoke attacks a vital gene which protects lung cells from cancer. One damaged cell is all it takes to start lung cancer growing. This is part of an aorta, the main artery from the heart. Smoking makes artery walls sticky and collect dangerous fatty deposits. This much was found stuck to the aorta wall of a smoker, age 32. Chemicals from tobacco smoke get into your bloodstream and can damage the delicate blood vessels inside your eye. We now know that smoking is a major cause of irreversible blindness. Every cigarette is doing you damage.
How does science advance the art of healing hearts. Through breakthrough discovery and treatment, the work of the foremost heart specialists at the region's only university medical center, the University of Toledo Medical Center, a higher degree of healing. How does discovery accelerate a stroke victim's recovery? Through breakthrough science and treatment, the work of the foremost neurologists at the region's only university medical center, the University of Toledo Medical Center, a higher degree of healing.
What about secondhand smoking?
How will you choose? How will you choose? You don't have a choice. Secondhand smoke is no different from active smoking. Both are hazardous to health.
Secondhand smoking can cause harm in many ways. Cause disease in children and adults who don't smoke. Actually, kill the exposed non-smokers. Smoking increases the risk for all types of cancers, heart disease, worsening asthma and respiratory infection, cause abortion, sudden infant death, infertility, and many other harms. There is no safe level of exposure to secondhand smoking. Any exposure is harmful. Smoking affects the whole family. I know you love your kids, but your smoking habit is hurting them. What would happen if they lose you?
This is how your child feels after losing you for a minute. Just imagine if they lost you for life.
Peer pressure makes it easy to start smoking, and much more difficult to quit. It wasn't until I saw the results of smoking in some of my dad's young patients that it scared me enough to quit. Be smart and quit today.
This is the truth about cigarettes. They are loaded with harmful chemicals, and the end result, they are a dangerous drug that can seriously harm all people, regardless of age.
Go to ToledoNewsNow.com and click on Toledo Cardiology Consultants.
Because time waits for no one. Kids today talk about smoking and peer pressure. They say they can quit at any time. They don't realize smoking is an addiction that could last a lifetime.
Why? Must there always be a reason? I don't know, at least, not anymore. I thought it was a solution at first, but then it turned into an addiction, a bad habit I couldn't break. I have no reason, because there are no good reasons when it comes to smoking.
Even some of them think it's cool or sexy. No matter how beautiful you are, smoking could harm you. Imagine yourself as this young lady. So no matter who you are, take this moment to think about yourself, your future, your kids, and the rest of the family. Do not find excuses to continue smoking, but find the courage to stop. Do not find the reason to continue, but find the reason to stop. Quit today, not tomorrow. Now, if you still have a doubt about the risk of smoking or still think you are safe while you are smoking, you need to see one more thing. You still have a chance to benefit from quitting. Harm could stop, and you could live a normal life if you quit at the right time.
You know that smoking is bad for your body. You also know that the longer you smoke, the worse it is for your body. But what you may not know is how good it is for your body to quit smoking, and that the longer you go without smoking, the healthier your body becomes. After only 20 minutes from your last cigarette, your blood pressure, pulse rate, and the temperature of your hands and feet all return to normal. After 8 hours, the nicotine in your bloodstream reduces by 93.25%. After 12 hours, your blood oxygen level increases to normal, while your carbon monoxide level drops to normal. After 24 hours, your quitting-related anxieties peak and will return to pre-quitting levels within 2 weeks. After 48 hours, damaged nerve endings are regrowing, and your sense of smell and taste are returning to normal. At this time, your quitting-related anger and irritability peak. After 72 hours, you are 100% nicotine free. Your withdrawal symptoms already peaked, the bronchial tubes in your lungs are relaxing, and you're now breathing easier. After 5 to 8 days, you're having an average of 3 cue-induced cravings each day, and no craving lasts longer than 3 minutes. After 10 days, you have less than 2 cravings a day, each less than 3 minutes. After 2 weeks, the blood circulation in your gums and teeth are similar to a non-smoker. After 2 to 4 weeks, your quitting-related anger, anxiety, impatience, insomnia, restlessness, and depression are gone. After 2 weeks to 3 months, your risk of heart attack is dropping and your lung function is improving. After 3 weeks to 3 months, your circulation is improved, your chronic cough disappeared, and you are walking easier. After 9 months, your sinus congestion, fatigue, and shortness of breath are decreased. The cilia in your lungs, which keep your lungs clean, are regrown, and you have increased energy. After 1 year, your excess risk of coronary heart disease, heart attack, and stroke are now half the excess risk of a smoker. After 5 to 15 years, your risk of having a stroke is the same as a non-smoker. After 10 years, your risk of lung cancer is 30 to 50% of a smoker's risk. Your risk of death from lung cancer is reduced by half, and your risk of pancreatic cancer is the same as a non-smoker. Your risk of mouth, throat, and esophagus cancer is also reduced. After 13 years, your risk of tooth loss is the same as a non-smoker. After 15 years, your risk of coronary heart disease is the same as a non-smoker. After 20 years, the risk of death from smoking-related causes is now that of a non-smoker. Good as new. Learn how to quit smoking and return your body to health. Visit quitsmoking.com.
Everyone asking why I'm very passionate about smoking. I can tell you a simple reason. My father and my brother smoked, and I had a very bad feeling about smoking since I was a young boy. The sad part that my brother died at age 46. It's very sad. That hit me very hard that probably we did not do a good job educating the public, educating ourselves. I wish my brother learned about smoking. I wish because he would be alive today.